Hi guys, welcome to my channel. This is introductory video part 2. Okay. Property number 1, angle sum property. The sum of the angles of a triangle is 180 degree. I think it's known to all. In most of the cases of triangle, we use this property. If ABC is a triangle, if I name is X, this is Y, this is Z, then angle X plus angle Y plus angle Z is equal to how much? 180 degree. Okay. Property number 2. Exterior angle property of a triangle. If a side of a triangle is produced, then the exterior angle so formed is equal to the sum of the two interior opposite angles. Okay. First of all, you should know what are exterior angles and what are interior angles. In this figure ABC, you see, if I name this angle 1, this angle 2, this angle 3, then these 3 angles are 3 interior angles. In a triangle, there are all total 3 interior angles. And now, I'm showing you about exterior angles. What are exterior angles? If I extend this A, I can extend it like this. You see, I can extend it like this, and also I can extend it like that way. Also, I can extend. So I can produce or extend in two ways. This A again, B also I can produce in two ways like this. I can produce. And here also, you see, in two ways B also can be produced, and this also C also can be produced in two ways. Okay, so this angle, when I produce in this way, you just forget about this extension, you think about this extension, then which angle is formed here? Exterior angle, this one. You see, if I forget about this angle, because this side is a straight line, so no angle is formed in that way. So here only one angle is formed in this side, with the side of the triangle, this side, AC, only one exterior angle is formed, and opposite to it, which angles are there? 2 and 3. Okay. So here also you see, in case of B, and if we think about this extension, not this one, then we will forget about this part, only this extension you think. Then you see here another exterior angle is formed, only one exterior angle is formed. If we extend in a single way, then we will find only one exterior angle, and which is equal to the other interior angles, sum of other two interior angles. Again, in case of B also, you see, in two ways we can extend it. If we extend in this way, you forget about this thing, then here one exterior angle is formed, which is equal to the sum of opposite. That means you, in that case, you just forget about the adjacent angle. Here, you think about other opposite two angles. So, this equal to other 1 plus 3, this exterior angle. Again, if we think about this one, you see, here one exterior angle is formed. Because in that way, there is no possibility of forming angle, because this is a straight line. So, only one angle is formed when we extend the side, and this will be equal to the sum of other opposite angles. Okay. So, here I have again drawn another triangle, ABC. Only one extension I have written. So, here angle A, if we write it as X, this one is Y, this one is Z. And this angle P, this angle Q, this angle R. Then, according to this theorem, exterior angle so formed is equal to the sum of the two interior opposite angles. Here, two interior angles are there because total three interior angles are there. So, one is adjacent to that exterior angle. So, we'll not count this angle. So apart from this X, only two angles are there, Y and Z. So according to this property, angle P is equal to angle Y plus z. And similarly, in case of B also, angle Q is equal to angle x plus angle z. And in case of this, angle r is equal to x plus y. Okay. 40 number 3. Triangle inequality property. It states the sum of the lengths of any two sides of a triangle is greater than the length of the third side. Okay. Here consider ABC is a triangle, and this opposite to vertex A, measure of this side is A, small letter I have written here, and this vertex opposite to B is a measure of this side is B, and measure of this side is C. Then according to this property, and A plus B, that means sum of any two side is greater than the third side. That means A plus B is greater than C. Again, B plus C is greater than A, and C plus A is greater than B. Length, all these lengths are greater than the third side. Okay. So, property number 4. Pythagoras theorem or property. This is a very important one, and this is named after the name of the founder. This Pythagoras is the founder of this theorem, and it states, in a right triangle, the square of the hypotenuse is equal to the sum of the squares of the other two sides. Okay, hypotenuse is the opposite to the right angle. This is called hypotenuse, and this one is base, this one is perpendicular. Okay, so if I denote this by A, this measure of this side is A, measure of this side is B, this side is C, then according to this theorem, B square is equal to, this is opposite to right angle, that means B square is equal to A square plus C square. Okay, and converse of the theorem is also there, and converse of the theorem states that if the square of one side of a triangle is equal to the sum of the squares of other two sides, then the triangle is a right triangle with the angle opposite to the first side as right angle. Okay, because opposite to the hypotenuse should be a right angle, and so this is the converse theorem, and this ABC are called Pythagorean triplet. Okay, so in our next video, I will solve some problems using all these properties. Thank you for watching. If you like the video, please don't forget to hit the subscribe button and share the video. And if you have any doubt, you can share it in below comment section. So see you guys in my next video. Till then, bye.